ready to go fishing. Rightio, I'm going to start off with the old egg beater first. I'm fishing the channel at the moment because it's not many snags here. And I'll give you a couple of casts and just give you a few ideas on how to go about it. Here we go. Always be careful of your hooks. Alright. Don't have to cast it out 100 friggin' miles. Alright. Here's the lure. Give him a couple quick pulls. Get him down to the depth. And a slow retrieve. As long as you see that line bouncing, you know your lure's working. If it stops bouncing, you've picked up a bit of weed or something, pull your line back in. Clear it weed. Have another cast. I'm not sure if you can see that. The slower you go, it's good, as long as the lure's working. If it's going straight past a big old lazy cod, good. Here's another style. When using hard bodies, get him down the depth. A couple quick ones. Retrieve, stop. Retrieve, stop. Retrieve, stop. Retrieve, stop. And if he's a lazy fish sitting there, and the old lure comes swimming past him and stops, he goes past the end, here we go. This cheeky bugger. Trying to sit there and tease me up. 99% of the times, if you've got it close enough to him and you're stopping retrieving, well, he won't be able to resist it. Rightio. Then I'll go to a little spinner bait. These ones, a little bit different technique because they actually swim different. They sit up that way, so it's a little bit harder for them to get snagged up, because once it passes over the snags, it'll swim that way and the hook is actually sitting up. If you do hit a snag, right, especially just keep the weight on it and give it a little flick, because if they do hit the snag and you stop, it'll actually roll over and it'll actually snag straight on and can be a bugger to get them off. These things, excellent, caught heaps and heaps of fish on them, heaps. This is only a little single spin, they have got two spinners. I do use quad spins, which actually have two of these sitting out either side, and they're actually quite good. These are just Colorado bronzes, but you can get willow leaf patterns, all sorts of patterns, different colours. Red and black around here, and Randall works pretty good. Pink and black, very good, trout cod love them. Yellow belly love these, I've actually tried yellow, green. Purple is another really good one. On my past video, I've got a 25-30 pounder in the channel on purple, and mate, nailed it. And squash your barbs too on your hooks. Like, it makes a small surface for the hook to go in, actually gets it in and hooks it up better. And when you do get to pull it out, it pulls out easy. Oh, that'll crack, I'll show you. I am right-handed, but I cast left-hand. Different styles, you can lead out one side. Let him sink to the bottom. Count, one, two, and that's at the bottom already. Give a quick lift, and then retreat, nice and slow. What you want to do is get the lure just above the bottom. Just get him in there working. Right, overhead. Seconds, quick lift, get off the bottom, slow retreat. Real slow, as long as you can just feel those spinners working. It's a little thin rod actually, so it's a little bit forgiving, you can actually feel a bit, little bit better. See, it wouldn't be bad if it was a smash rod now. We'll go two-handed, just whatever you prefer. Once you count down, when it first initial cast, and you count 3 seconds to 10 seconds, whatever it is before it hits the bottom, cast out again and start retrieving a second or two short, and that way you won't have to lift it. So I'll go out, let him out, one, two, retrieve, and that should be just above the bottom. Keep your lure down once it's out, and as it gets closer, because it'll probably sink a little bit quicker. Slowly raise your rod so as you keep it up a bit better so it won't sit down and hit the bottom. And I'm fishing in a rocky area here, and if you let it sink too much and it'll get stuck in the rocks, it'll get stuck. And unless you've got a little retriever, you won't get it back. Alright? Alrighty. This one back out of the road, out of water. And they look pretty cool swimming actually, these ones. Got a light little flash over the top. I'm not quite sure what attracts it, but I think it's vibration, noise, and yeah, the flash of actually the spinners attracts them as well. You can get lure attractant that you can actually get on your lure and squeeze. I don't usually use it because if you get it in front of him, mate, he's just going to nail it anyway if he's hungry enough. And usually cotter territorial, so they don't necessarily have to be hungry to actually nail the lure. Just because they don't want you there, they don't want anything sitting in their little spot, well, they'll nail it and get out. Right, next one I'm going to use is Jackal. Another Rambler. These ones will actually sink, they won't float. Actually, what I forgot to tell you is with those other lures, the hard body ones, if you're running down and hit a snag, actually release it and it'll actually float up around the snag, keep retrieving, and it'll go back down and back down the depth. Then keep going, hit another snag, let it go, and it'll actually float up away from the snag and go. With these ones, they'll sink like a stone to the bottom, and you just have to jib, jib, jib with these. And I found you've got trebles on the front, trebles on the back. Just take those two, that hook off there, off the front, which actually will be sitting down that way. And when it's going along, it'll actually go across like that, and it actually won't hook up as quick. There's a handy little hit, and they are still there. If they're going to nail it, you'll get hooked, because there are five there instead of six. But I've been using it for ages, and I've nailed good yellows and good little cod on them. And taking that extra hook off is just beneficial, for sure. I'll show you how this one goes. Different style altogether. Already know it's going to go about 3 seconds. Get it down. Slight lifts, just when you release it, let it sink a bit and just wind that little bit of loose line as you go along. I'm not sure if you can see it in the video, but if you're jigging like that, you actually practice just in the shallows. Once you jib, jib, jibbing up and down, it actually looks like a wounded fish, and the yellow belly love it. They can't resist a wounded fish because they are predatory fish. And hopefully got it in the right spot. Another one. Sometimes it's not really deep enough here at the moment. Sometimes what you do is go jib, jib, jib and just hold it still and just let it flutter and then give another quick flutter. Another style is cast out, let him hit the bottom. Says now, and just click, let it hit the bottom. Wait for a second, let it hit the bottom. And the vibration, whatever, should attract him. He's sitting on the bottom, and all of a sudden just whizzes straight past him. Nail it. I'll just keep casting here for a bit, see how I go. I reckon, buddy.